Hey guys, Paisteboy here. I got a new Weber Master Touch kettle grill. I'm gonna assemble it and then I'm gonna try it out for the first time. From what I can see, they make a really good grill, so I think I'm gonna like the results. They make a bunch of accessories for it. I'll show you what it comes with, and there's some other stuff you can get aftermarket that work pretty well with it from what I've heard online. So let's get started. All right, so this is the box that it comes in, and like I said, it's the Master Touch model, and that's the number down there. I happen to pick this one up at Home Depot, but you can get them anywhere, Amazon, stuff like that. They're around $200 for this model. So these are the tools you'll need: block of wood, Phillips head screwdriver, small hammer, and the wrench that the grill came with. This first box that I took out has the two charcoal holders in it. That's what's in that box. You can put charcoal in here and put it anywhere you want inside the kettle. So you can do offset grilling if you needed to. All right, so this is the lid. And it already comes with the little vent on it, and it has a handle on the vent here, so you don't you're not touching bare metal. I'm gonna set this aside. Okay, and then this next box is the ash collector, and also inside here is all the hardware that you'll need for the rest, most of the other components. Here's the base, and already connected to the base is the vent control. It's also to clean out the ash. Set this aside. Also comes with this warming rack. Got three legs, two wheels, and the hubcaps were inside the ash collector for these, because they'll get a hubcap on there. It's the base, so you get your two wheels on here. The other end goes up to a leg. This is the top grate, and these two sides flip open, so you could add ash to those from these ends, or not ash, so you could add charcoal from the ends, the middle. Once you cut these straps off, this is removable, and there's accessories that you could get for this that will fit right in there. This is the grate. It goes in the bottom of the ash collector there, well, bottom of the kettle to hold your charcoal. This ring goes on the kettle so that you can, it'll hold the lid when you open it, and you'll see how that works once we get this together. So, now I'm gonna leave this stuff here and get started with step one. All right, so let me show you what was inside the ash collector. So we've got some hardware here that are for the lid holder assembly. This is a bracket that goes on the back of the kettle, and then these are like rollers for the lid, and some hardware for the wheels here and whatnot, and the legs. Got the thermometer, the handle for the lid. I'm sorry, no, this is the handle for the actual kettle, the base of the kettle, and this is the handle for the lid. And that little wrench that it comes with is in there. And that's pretty much everything. There's a couple nuts in here and bolts, but not very much hardware at all. And then we'll take it step by step of how to put it together. The one thing that you want to just notice right off the bat is that the handle on the base is there, so you're going to want to put the wheel legs in these two holes and the stationary leg here, so when you lift it you can roll it. I saw a display model at Target today, and they had it sideways, and now you try to lift the thing and you can't roll it anywhere because the legs are in the wrong position. So keep that in mind
Now if you look here, you'll see that two of the legs have this flattened area with a hole in it, and one is just tubular on both ends. So these two are the ones that get the wheels. So these will be the two going in these two holes. And this will be the one that goes toward the handle on the kettle. The first step says to put the little clips inside the leg sockets, figure three here. So I'm going to take those out of the bag and we're going to get these clipped into these three positions. So these are the three little clips. I'm going to slip it inside one of these leg sockets, and then the little button or pin will come out through the hole, and I'll show you that. All right, so if you look down here, you'll see there's a hole right here, and then we've got our piece with the pin. We're gonna just slip that in there, and that's as simple as that. And you do that on all three. All right, next we're gonna take the base of the collection bin here, and we're gonna take it with these clips facing down toward the kettle as the kettle's upside down, and we're gonna feed it through this lever and then just line it up until we'll spin it until we get one of the legs in place. Now it kind of feels like you're forcing it and it's bending and whatnot, but it'll fit into place. Just make sure you get the three pins lined up underneath the leg socket. All right, so the next step shows to take your two angled end legs and put them one on each side of the base here. And then you're gonna put one wheel on one side and then pound one of these caps that come with it on to hold the wheel on, and then you'll repeat that process on the other side. All right, so you're going to want to make sure that you've got your leg going the same angle as the base. You don't want to put it on backwards like this. Make sure it's facing in like that. Make sure you put your wheel with the spokes facing on the inside. I'm going to take your cap and hold it on. Try to keep it level so it goes on straight. Start tapping lightly and there you go. That's all the way on. Flip it over and do the same thing on the other side. It does come with a third cap in case you make a mistake on the first one. So try to get it right the first time, but they do include a third one in case you mess up. All right, now you're gonna wanna slip the two legs with the wheels on it in these two rear holes with the kettle handle in front. And you're gonna wanna make sure that the hook is facing down. I am going to give you a word of advice, and just make sure that this hoop is in this orientation and not inside here when you clip the two legs in. And also, you may want to just take these pieces here and clip them into the tube leg and then insert it into the base. I think it'll go a lot easier. I'm gonna try that with the third remaining leg. All right, now on this third leg without the flattened end, you'll notice that one end has a hole that's about an inch away from the end, and the other end of it has one that's about 4 inches away from the end. So you're going to put the little rubber foot on the end that is 4 inches away. So this little plastic cap goes on the end with the hole that is about 4 inches away. You can just press that on by hand. And then I'm going to put that clip that's currently on the leg socket on the kettle on this leg instead. So put that on like that, feed it in until it snaps in. Don't get it lost inside there if you try this. Then you have to feed that hook through this hole. Just like that. And then we can connect this socket down in there. So I'm gonna zoom in here. And don't use a hammer or anything to try to force this in. You'll ruin it. You just have to do it all by hand. We'll get it started and push the little button in and just finish pushing it in until it pops out. And we've got the base fully assembled. Now, I'm not sure if you're supposed to put the ash collector on now, but I guess now is as good a time as any. So with it in the upside down position, because the kettle's upside down, it's got these two pins, and you're gonna just slide them into those slots in there and just push it down in. Boom, connected. All right, base is fully assembled. I'm gonna flip her over. And now you can see why you need the wheels where they are and where the handle is on the bottom of the kettle, so you can wheel it. Now, some people might say, oh, it's a little wobbly and this and that, but it's strong and you can take it apart if you need to bring it somewhere with you. So not a big deal. Also, a tripod is the most stable of platforms, three legs, because if one spot is uneven, it will still balance on three legs. That's why they make camera tripods that way. If you had four legs and now you try to balance it, if one spot's off, the thing's gonna be rickety. It would have to be on a flat surface. So three legs are better than four. All right, next we're gonna take care of the hood holder. And so we have this half hoop here, this metal bracket, these two graphite rollers, some hardware, and a small bracket. And we're gonna put it together as it shows here. So we need to feed this through the bracket like that. Okay, so we got that. Got our hardware. So you'll notice here's the handle at the back of the kettle. There's a hole here and a hole here, and we're going to put the rod, that hoop shaped rod, on the back. And before we put them in, we have to put graphite roller, I believe these are graphite, right on there. So let's do that. So we're gonna take our hood holder, put this roller on it, and then we're gonna put a washer on. Feed it through the hole. Put another washer on and a nut. I'm just gonna get that hand tight and go do the other side. Put the roller on, washer on, put it through the hole, another washer, and a nut. Kind of hard to do with one hand here. I should be holding the other end of that, but I got it. Okay, and then we're just going to lightly tighten those for now. Could actually use the little wrench that it came with to tighten up these nuts. And these rollers are supposed to move. Okay. Now you'll see down here, toward the bottom of the kettle is another hole, and it's square. And that's where you'll attach this bracket here. Get it lined up like that. And then there's a third piece. So this is the bracket. It'll go behind this like so. And we will put the carriage bolt in here and through here and then through the kettle. Then on the inside of the kettle, you'll put one washer and one nut. And then I'm going to use the wrench that it came with to tighten it up. So I'm just going to push on the carriage bolt on the outside and tighten it up on the inside. That's it. Now it does show using a wrench on the directions, but I don't really think you need it. These are kind of locking nuts, so you should be fine just with that much. If you do notice them loosening up over time, I guess you can get your wrench in there. Get that lined up. So just make sure your bracket is right in the middle there. If it wasn't, like mine, you can just push it into place. And that's what that'll look like. Now we're on to the lid assembly, which you have to put the handle on. And we actually have to put the little handle on this to complete that as well. Some of these steps don't have to do in the exact order. It is now saying on step 9 to put the ash bin in, but I already did that earlier on when we put the holder on for the ash bin. So we've already got that done. It's now saying in step 10 to put all the inner pieces in, but that can be done at the very end, and that's when I'll show you those. Now we're going to put the handle on the actual base of the kettle, and that will just require a Phillips screwdriver. It comes with one screw, and let's get that put on. All right, two pieces to the handle here. So this piece goes on the inside, put it in on angle, and then just kind of snap it in place. Make sure your Weber logo is facing the right direction. You'll see at the end here, there's two little hooks for your utensils. You'll just push this on, and then you've got a Phillips head screw and your screwdriver. Don't over tighten it, it's just plastic, and there you go. You got your two little hangers. All right, so there's three last steps to do. We've got the hubcaps to put on, the handle on the lid, and then the thermometer on the lid, and that's it. So let's tackle those. All right, so this is the handle that goes on the lid. Comes with the two nuts already on the lid. They're not exactly the typical type of nuts you'd see, but they'll do the trick. So we're gonna take them off. And it really doesn't matter which way it goes, but since the Weber on the vent is going to be facing that way, I'm going to make the handle face the same way. Lift it up. Get one of these flat nuts. And get it started. Okay, and then the other one. Then get the little tool that it came with and give it a tighten. Done. So let's take a look at it this way. See your Weber here, Weber here. And then this is where the thermometer goes. We're gonna open that up and attach the thermometer. It'll come in this green packaging. Open it up. This just has a wing nut. So you don't even need any tool to put that on. So it comes with like a little base, which
has a little locking spot that'll go through that slot here. And the thermometer itself. Now the one thing that I've seen with other people using this grill is that the thermometer is accurate, but because it's, if you're doing offset cooking and you need your vent on the side with your food that you want to be offset cook, your temperature on this side where your coals are is going to read hotter than where your meat is. So a lot of guys use a second thermometer to gauge how hot their meat is on the indirect side. So I just slipped the thermometer into there. You'll see on the back, it actually will only go on the base one way. We will put it through here, get it locked in there. Lift the lid, make sure you don't drop it. Put your wing nut on, don't cross thread it. What I typically do is I'll spin it backwards a couple times until you feel it fall into the correct position and then start screwing it on. And there we go. That's completely on. Lid is done. Now we're gonna put the hubcaps on. So let's put the hubcaps on. They look like this. Just got a little Weber Kettle grill emblem on there, embossed. So I think you just press them on. Just line up the holes. The holes here, doesn't really matter how you start it, just get them lined up. There you go. And repeat on the other side. All right, now we're gonna put all the pieces inside the grill. Oh, let me just show you real quick. When you spin the lever on the bottom, you've got fully closed. You know, might want to put a mark on your ash collector on where slightly open is, full open is, and then when you're cleaning out your ash, you're just going to spin it back and forth. This piece here is for the charcoal to rest on, so we'll put that on like that. Then these are the two ash or charcoal holders. You know, if you want to put charcoal on each side instead of right down on this grate, and then you'll have just heat on the ends, or you can put them together in the middle, and you'll see where that might come in handy later. So put that down like that, and we'll take the main grill here, and since this is the back of the grill here where the lid is going to open to, you kind of want to get this set like that, so these flaps can open and you can add charcoal from here while you're cooking. Now I'm just going to cut these zip ties off and show you how this piece works. So this comes out and you could actually bring your ash bins into the middle and do some searing if you wanted to, straight in the middle with these. Or you can buy other accessories that will go in place right there of this centerpiece. But if you just want a straight up grill, leave it there. Now I'll show you how the lid goes on. So, all right, so you can adjust your vents, fully closed, fully open, quarter open, third open, whatever, for your heat desired. Thermometers on this side. And then when you open the grill, that's where those rollers come in, just like that. You don't have to hook it onto the side of the kettle. It's going to hold just like that. Roll it back, pull it, boom, locked on. And there you go. So we'll just do a quick walk around here of the complete Weber Master Touch kettle grill, fully assembled. Your thermometer.
And I don't know what you're really going to put on the bottom there, not much, but it's just there to really hold the thing together. And then if you're lifting the lid, and you got it just like that. Oh yeah, I almost forgot the warming rack. Let me grab that. So there's the warming rack. You just put that in there when you want to use it, or if you want to use it. You don't have to use it. If you don't want to use it, take it out, put it aside. If you need it, then simply put it in there. This is the 22 inch Weber Master Touch kettle grill. Here's three additional items I decided to purchase while getting the kettle. This is the Weber chimney for starting your charcoal. It's well built and it's large. It's got a great two handles on here. So you can pour them two-handed. I bought some of the Weber lighter cubes so you could get your charcoal started easier. And I just bought a long lighter so that I can light the lighter cubes comfortably from a distance instead of using a small lighter. Other than that, there's a ton of things you can get in addition to this, but some of those things you probably already have. All right, guys, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up if it was helpful. Please check the links in the description. You might find something down there useful. You could also pick up this grill from the link below if you're interested. And check out some of my suggestions at the end of this video. You might find them interesting too. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Take care.